Divide and conquer technique of Nicholas Practice is a basic technique that every phaco surgeon starts their training with. It is ideal for denser cataract. So the first step in successful divide and conquer lens removal is the creation of adequate capsular rexis. The rexis should be no larger than 5 to 6 mm and as round as possible and centered on visual axis. Next is good hydro procedures, as divide and conquer technique requires rotation of nucleus from 90 to 270 degrees. A good hydro dissection or delineation and dissection is mandatory. Then comes the phaco settings. A moderate flow, low vacuum and continuous phaco power is needed. Power used is based on nuclear density. Harder nuclei needs higher power, as insufficient power causes phaco probe to push the nucleus forward, resulting in zonular stress. On the other hand, high vacuum levels can cause nucleus to stick to the phaco tip and may inhibit smooth movements of the tip through the nucleus.
Faisal, are you muted?
Faisal? Am I audible now?
Yeah, go ahead.
So this is a video of divide and conquer technique in a harder cataract. First, loose cortical fibers and epinucleus overlying the nucleus should be cleared in foot position 2 alone or with minimal application of phaco power. Be careful not to touch the edges of the capsule rim. And next step is to sculpt a groove in the center of the nucleus. So it is started with developed position of phaco tip. So during superficial groove, sculpting should be stopped short of the rexis and the subsequent grooves can be taken beyond the rexis rim. The groove should be 1.5 times the width of the phaco tip to prevent the sleeve pushing the nucleus. So during each sculpting motion, the morphology of the lens should be kept in mind. So that is the downslope sculpting initially should be followed by upslope sculpting and beyond the center of the nucleus. The ultrasound power should be used only during forward movement of the tip and the foot pedal should return to position 1 during reverse movement. But so on the distal side, the nucleus can be sculpted slightly further towards the periphery, but under the site of the entry wound, the groove cannot extend as far peripheral due to capsular rim and angulation of phaco tip. So the nucleus is rotated 180 degree and the groove extended. And now the second groove is made 90 degree to the first loop. This need not be wider. A clear reflex is in comparison to the rest of the nucleus indicates satisfactory depth, after which the groove should not be deepened. So this is the other part of second groove. This need not be wider. So once a pair of cross grooves are created on the nucleus, now it is time for cracking. So the cracking can be done either by two choppers or with chopper and the phaco tip. Here I am using conventional cracking technique. Both the instruments are placed deep in the groove and the quadrants are separated with outward and slightly upward motion. Make sure the posterior plate is cracked. If the crack is incomplete, then the instruments can be moved towards unsplit area and repeat the maneuver. If the split does not go all the way through the depth of the nucleus, then the groove may need to be further deepened to complete the split. Next is quadrant removal. Increase the parameters to better draw the nucleus quadrant into the tip and start MLCing and aspirate the nucleus. So this this is a video of divide and conquer technique in soft cataract. There are few tips that we have to follow when doing divide and conquer in soft cataracts. First is the groove here has to be narrow. This will later help in cracking. And next is the nucleus does not extend all the way to the edges of the lens. So it is not necessary to sculpt all the way out. During sculpting, it is important to remember that the lens is on an average 9.4 mm across and 4.5 mm in maximum thickness in the center and rapidly thins towards the periphery. So by making long trench, you may end up puncturing the posterior capsule before we could react to it. So for softer cataract, sometimes I prefer to do both hydro delineation and dissection, which gives me an idea how long the trench has to be. And next is the red reflex. Nowadays, newer microscopes comes with excellent coaxial illumination, giving bright reflex even in a denser nuclei. So sometimes this sign might not be absolutely dependent on. As I mentioned before, the adult lens is 4.5 mm thick and the post phaco tip is 1 mm. So 3 phaco tips deep groove is adequate, giving thin posterior plate, which will be easier to crack. Next is cracking. Cracking is comparatively difficult in softer cataracts, often ends in cheese wiring. So make sure you have made a narrow and deep trench and start cracking from periphery after placing two instruments deep in the groove. Once all the quadrants are cracked, now the parameters can be increased to draw the nucleus into the phaco tip. The first quadrant might be adamant due to 90 degree angles, so you can use a second instrument to bring the nucleus to the center and then aspirate it. Then the remaining nucleus quadrant can be brought to the center and emulsified and aspirated. So the take-home message here is, while making groove, make wider groove for denser nuclei and narrower groove for softer cataracts. The morphology of lens should be kept in mind always. That is, the downslope sculpting initially should be followed by upslope sculpting beyond the center of the nucleus. The clear red reflex in comparison to the rest of the nucleus indicates satisfactory depth, so after which the groove should not be deepened. And for cracking, efficient cracking, place the instruments deep in the groove and the quadrants are separated with outward and slightly upward motion.